How much longer will there be no more Royal Caribbean cruises, construction delays, and a virtual cruise too? Here's all of this week's Royal Caribbean news up next. Hey everyone, it's Matt from RoyalCaribbeanBlog.com. Thanks for joining, and I hope everyone watching is staying safe out there. This week, I have a roundup of all the Royal Caribbean happenings, and unfortunately, a lot of it's not great news. Let's begin with Royal Caribbean's announcement that it has extended its voluntary suspension of sailings for an additional 30 days. The cruise line had already canceled all sailings through April 10th, and now will cancel all cruises through May 11th, 2020. Royal Caribbean says it expects to return to service on May 12th, 2020. Now, in addition to that, due to port closures around the world, Royal Caribbean added they expect to return to service in Alaska, Canada, and New England sailings on July 1st, 2020. Just like the previous 30 days of canceled sailings, anybody who's been impacted by this round of cancellations can choose between a 100% refund or a 125% future cruise credit. Future cruise credits will be automatically issued on April 30th, 2020. Any pre-purchased amenities and packages such as internet, beverage, dining, or Royal Up upgrades will automatically be refunded, and Royal Caribbean Travel Protection Insurance will also be refunded. Moving on, there's also two different Royal Caribbean construction projects that are now on hold. Royal Caribbean's brand new headquarters will remain under construction for a little while longer. Construction work for the cruise line's $300 million corporate headquarters in Port Miami is on hold due to prohibitions on non-essential activities and restrictions on public gatherings. Work on the site will cease, with the exception of the parking lot adjacent to the building that will be completed as planned. Work will resume at, quote, the appropriate time, according to Royal Caribbean. In addition, Royal Caribbean has petitioned the Port of Galveston to delay the start of construction on a brand new cruise terminal by about a year. Royal Caribbean still wants to build a new $100 million, 150,000 square foot cruise terminal, just not this year. The delay is not official yet, and that the Port and Royal Caribbean must agree on new terms. Prior to this proposed delay, the new terminal was slated to open in November 2021. Now, to help solidify Royal Caribbean's cash flow during this crisis, the cruise line recently took out a $2.2 billion, that's with a B, dollar loan. Royal Caribbean Cruises Limited Executive Vice President and Chief Financial Officer Jason Liberty quoted, "This is a period of unprecedented disruption for the cruise industry. We continue to take decisive actions to protect the company's financial and liquidity positions as they enable us to keep us focused on our guests, our crew, and our long-term plans," end quote. The facility can be extended at the company's option for an additional 364 days. The company has borrowed the full amount available under the term loan to further bolster its liquidity. In addition, the company has committed financing for all of its new ships on order. I do have some fun news to share this week because a former Royal Caribbean cruise director has created a week-long virtual cruise for everybody stuck at home. There are a lot of cruise fans out there, like me, who are stuck at home and dreaming of the day they can get back on board a Royal Caribbean cruise. So, former cruise director Abe Hughes decided to offer a virtual cruise for them. Dubbed Virtual of the Seas, Hughes crafted a daily cruise compass to provide his friends at home activities that would not only keep them occupied, but were similar to the sort of activities you would find on a cruise. Each day, there was a brand new cruise compass that he would post online for anyone interested to read that has activities that they could do at home as well as collaborate online. This included Sudoku, trivia, napkin folding, and more. Now, this idea has proven so popular that Royal Caribbean announced Virtual of the Seas will sail again with a four-night cruise that began on March 30th. Speaking of things to do while you're at home instead of on a cruise, did you know that one of Royal Caribbean's favorite performers is live streaming from home? If you've been lucky enough to catch a performance of Billy Pondo in the Schooner Bar on a Royal Caribbean cruise ship, then you know just how talented this man is at his craft. Billy Pondo is Royal Caribbean's go-to A-list performer each evening on the most important sailings, and you can now watch some of Billy's live performances on his Facebook page. Next up, if you want to impress your coworkers, be sure to check out the new cruise-inspired Zoom backgrounds to use in your meetings. With more and more people relying now on virtual meetings held with the popular Zoom app, Royal Caribbean released new virtual backgrounds that anyone can start using. The virtual backgrounds include scenes from Perfect Day at Cocoa Key, the Cocoa Beach Club, Navigator of the Seas, Schooner Bar, Alaska, Royal Promenade, and more. And I'm going to wrap up our news with some positivity and one of the best stories that came out of this week. Cruise ships from Royal Caribbean, Holland America, Celebrity Cruises, and more joined together for an impromptu show of support for each other during the time of crisis when all the cruise lines have halted sailings. Celebrity Cruises Captain Kate McHugh shared a video on Instagram of captains and bridge crew from across different cruise companies engaging in a horn salute every day at 7:30 p.m. Captain MeQ calls this movement hashtag hope floats, and it is about letting everyone know that they are safe on board and that they wish for the same for everyone around the world. Quote, we sound our horns to let our crew and the world know that while we are strong, safe, and healthy on board, we're thinking of those at home and hoping the same for them, end quote. The ships are massed together in the Caribbean as cruise ships wait for cruise lines to resume operations. So there's our news for right now, and thank you so much for listening, and thanks for watching. I know these are tough times, and I really appreciate all of you, my friends, checking this out. If you're new to my videos, be sure to subscribe to Royal Caribbean Blog so you can be part of the fun. This has been Matt from RoyalCaribbeanBlog.com, and we'll talk again real soon.